All right, so we kind of zoomed ahead to the end there. So let's take a step back and walk through what I just did, but much more slowly. You're going to see all the steps that I went through when I wrote the Python code that just made that decision boundary. And by the end of the next video or two, you will be able to write this code yourself. So the place that we start, as always maybe, is Google. So there's a Python library that I'm going to be using a lot in this lesson, and we're going to be using Google to help us use the documentation of that library to figure out how to use some of the functions that it has. The name of this library is sklearn, which is often abbreviated sklearn, so let me get you used to that convention now. So I'm going to search Google for sklearn and the name of the algorithm that I just used, which happens to be naive Bayes. We'll go back in a little bit and talk about what naive Bayes does exactly, but first I want you to have you running the code. So sklearn naive Bayes, see what's out there. There's a page on naive Bayes here that gives you a derivation of the naive Bayes formula and then a bunch of use cases, including something that says Gaussian naive Bayes, and as it turns out, this is what I'm going to be using. So let's head back, because I saw Gaussian naive Bayes as one of the other results on Google. That's this one, Gaussian naive Bayes. This is the way that I actually wrote classifier that you just saw.